Welcome, Kids Sarah Online Kids Church. Today, again, my name is Pastor Stephen. We're welcoming you and we thank you for joining us today.
This is my faith, this is my focus, all of my days, I know where my hope is. I live it loud, I shout the chorus, because I know, oh, you're always for us. And even when it's hard for me to see, I will trust in you, I will believe, believe. And even when it's hard for me to see, I will trust in you, I will believe. And keep on looking, for where I'm going, knowing you'll go there too. I'll keep on looking, looking, looking to you. I fix my eyes on you. This is my focus, all of my days, I know where my hope is. I live it loud, I shout the chorus, because I know, oh, you're always for us. And even when it's hard for me to see, I will trust in you, I will believe, believe. And even when it's hard for me to see, I will trust in you, I will believe. And keep on looking, looking, looking to you. For where I'm going, knowing you'll go there too. I'll keep on looking, looking, looking to you. I'll fix my eyes on you.
Today we have a fabulous lesson and we have a great theme that we're going to be using for this month of June. And today, again, we have none other than LaTanya.
Today we are talking about faith, which means to have complete trust or confidence in someone or something. Now, we may not realize it, but we believe a lot of things are true without ever seeing it or knowing it for sure. Oh, you don't believe me? Let me give you some examples. First, a chair. So when you plop down on your comfortable couch or chair, ask yourself this. Do you check to see if it's there before you sit down? Because normally we don't. Without checking to see if our chair is still in the same place that we left it, we automatically just sit down because we somehow know it's gonna be there. And most of the times, we're right. Second, the weather. Now we rarely doubt the meteorologists on TV when they report the weather to us. They tell us it's going to rain, and we bring our umbrellas when we go outside. If they tell us it's going to be super hot, we bring our sunscreen and our sunglasses. Now, we have no idea if they're actually going to be right, and there really isn't any way to check if what they're reporting is true, but yet, we believe it. Lastly, myths. We have all been told at some point in our lives, usually by our parents, that reading in the dark will damage our eyesight, or looking too close at our devices will damage our eyesight. Now, without any real proof or real life examples of people who've actually gotten bad eyesight by doing this activity, we automatically believe it. See, we all believe things without seeing them and without proof, AKA, we all have faith in different things. But today, we want to talk about what it means to trust God completely, and not because you can see Him, but because you know about Him. So our first Bible scripture is Hebrews 11, verse 1, and it says, "Now faith is confidence in what we hope for, and assurance about what we do not see." Now throughout the Bible, there are countless examples of people who were able to do amazing things because they had enough faith in God. Now even though they could not see Him. So you had Noah, who by faith built an ark after God warned that there was going to be a massive flood, even though there were no signs of a flood. And the weather reporter didn't even say anything about any rain. Noah ended up saving his entire family. Then there was Abraham, a super duper old man and his wife, also super duper old, whom God promised a baby to. And by faith, they trusted that God would deliver. And at like 100 years old, like I told you, super duper old, him and his wife, Sarah, had their first son together. The reason we can have faith in God without seeing Him and without proof is because we know about who God is. And we have a long history of God's faithfulness in our hands. It's called the Bible. Because we know that God is not a God who should lie, that He loves His children, and would not deny them what they need, we can have faith in God. And all that is right in here. But that is the same logic that we use with everything else we have faith in that we can't see. See, you can sit on a chair without looking to see it's there because we know where the chair is. We can trust the weather reporter is telling the truth about the rain coming our way because we know that the last few weather reports have been accurate. And most of all, we can trust our parents when they tell us things like, don't breathe in the dark because it's bad for your eyes, because we know that they love us and want us to be safe. Now, it's the same thing with God. What we know about God helps us to have faith in Him, even though we can't really see Him. We've seen what He can do, and some of us have heard about what He's done, and that allows us to have the utmost confidence in Him.
God picked a great piece of land for His people, the Israelites, to live in, called the Promised Land. Remember, God sent Moses to free the Israelites from slavery in Egypt so He could lead them to the Promised Land. The long story short was because they disobeyed God, they weren't able to reach the Promised Land. After Moses, God chose Joshua to be their new leader because he was really good at obeying God in the small things and the big things. But the first big obstacle Joshua and his people faced on their way to the Promised Land was that there was a huge big city filled with their enemies called Jericho, which was protected by a very big tall wall that was made to protect the city. Joshua did not have a plan to get past that wall, but know that his big God did.
So if you have your Bibles, join with me or your Bible app. We're going to read Joshua 6, verse 1. Now the gates of Jericho were securely barred because of the Israelites. No one went out and no one came in. Then the Lord said to Joshua, "See, I have delivered Jericho into your hands, along with its king and its fighting men. So march around the city once with all the armed men. Do this for 6 days. Have 7 priests carry trumpets of ram's horns in front of the ark. On the 7th day, march around the city 7 times with the priest, blowing the trumpets. Now when you hear them sound a long blast on the trumpets, then have the whole army give a loud shout. Then the wall of the city will collapse and the army will go up, everyone straight in." So Joshua, son of Nun, called the priests and said to them, "Take up the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord and have 7 priests carry trumpets in front of it." And he ordered the army, "Advance, march around the city with an armed guard, going ahead of the Ark of the Lord." When Joshua had spoken to the people, the 7 priests carrying the 7 trumpets before the Lord went forward, blowing their trumpets, and the Ark of the Lord's covenant followed them. And we read on in verse 15, "On the 7th day, they got up at daybreak and marched around the city 7 times in that same manner, except that on the day they circled the city 7 times. The 7th time around, when the priests sounded the trumpet blast, Joshua commanded the army, 'Shout, for the Lord has given you the city.'" And verse 20 says, "When the trumpet sounded, the army shouted, And at the sound of the trumpet, when the man gave a loud shout, the wall collapsed. So everyone charged straight in and they took the city.
This story is something we can all relate to because of the faith Joshua had to have, even when he did not see how God was working in his situation. Joshua commanded his entire army to walk around the huge wall for 7 days straight. And each day he walked around the wall, nothing changed. In fact, you can imagine the people of Jericho mocking Joshua and his army and laughing at them each and every day. No matter how hard they marched or believed, the wall stayed the same, big, tall, and unbreakable. But Joshua cemented his faith, trust, and belief in God of Israel, who had brought them victory after victory against all of their enemies. Sometimes, in our lives, we face our own Jericho, something that we have to try to overcome or accomplish. And we can't do it on our own. So we have to ask God for help. Do you oftentimes ask God for help in your situations? Even though the walls continue to stand and the people continue to mock him, what encouraged him to keep marching was God's word and his promise. The word of the all-knowing God spoken over his life assisted and directed Joshua's future plan. God said, "I have delivered Jericho into your hands." You remember that word? That means that God had a plan. So every day that Joshua marched that march around the city, he did not let what he saw discourage him. Instead, he allowed the spoken word of God over his life and what he knew about God and his promises to encourage him. Remember, God will not go back on his word. What he said he will do, he, God, will cause it to happen or to come through for each and every one of us. But then on the seventh day, his army shouted in victory. But notice that victorious cry happened even before the wall fell down. One of the biggest things that pleases God is our faith. You see, their faith was so big enough to praise God before the miracle happened. And as soon as God saw how strong their faith and their obedience was, the wall came down. If Joshua had based his faith on what he saw, then he and his army would have given up and his people would be no closer to the promised land. But because his faith was based on the word that was spoken of his life and the promise that God gave him, Joshua continued to march in faith until his Jericho came down. What is your Jericho, kids? Is it better grades at school? Some sick relative wishing to be healed? A new home for your family? Not having people influence you negatively in your life to do wrong? You wanted to be a better person, or you're just worrying what the future holds? Faith in God ensures that we can rest in the truths of the God of the Bible. It is the dependence of an individual or someone submitting to God, believing in him. What are you believing God to do in your life? And are you basing your faith on what you see or on what you know about God and what he can do? We know he is loving and he loves you. And he keeps that promise that he is forgiving, that he helps us to overcome any obstacle that we may face. So are you going to be like Joshua and march around your obstacles, trusting that God will make them fall? Or are you going to give up because it doesn't look like you are going to win? I want to encourage you today to march around that wall, whatever stands before you, with faith in God, and watch the miracles he will do in your life and watch Jericho fall. I just want to leave a word with you. Faith is spelled, forgetting all others, I trust in him.
Wow, what a powerful story. I am sure that we have all been Joshua at some points in our lives. Maybe that's the situation that you're in right now. You see, Joshua teaches us that we can't live by what we see because there's always more to the story. There are so many times in our lives where we doubted people and things because of what we saw, only to be so surprised at the end. For example, in the 2019 NBA Finals, the Raptors were versing the Golden State Warriors, a great team that had won the championship 6 times of 4. Yes, I did my homework. Unlike the Raptors, which had never won a championship, the Golden State Warriors were the Raptors' Jericho because they were blocking them from winning. Now, from what we saw, there were 46 seconds left in the game, and the Raptors were down by 3, making it hard to believe that they could win. But as those seconds went by, we saw the Raptors gain 7 points in under 1 minute. Now, those true Raptors fans had faith that their team would win, and not because they based their trust in what they saw, but in what they knew about the talented and skillful players on the team. Then, the whole city erupted with cheer, because finally, our Toronto Raptors were victorious. Even those that thought they were going to lose, they cheered as well. So here's the question that I have for you. Are you like those diehard fans in the stands that believe that even though it doesn't look like you're going to win the championship, that God is powerful enough to help you make those last 7 points before the time runs out? Are you like Joshua and his army that walked around the city 7 times, believing that God will allow them to be the champions by making that wall fall? If we are those true diehard fans, then like the people in the stands during the Raptors' final game, we should cheer and praise God before the miracle happens, before he makes us make those last 7 magical shots, before he helps us to tear down those obstacles. We should praise him by faith, knowing that he will come through and allow us to be champions over our Jerichos. So join me as we pray. God, we ask that you give us the strength to have faith in you and realize that it doesn't have to be about what we see, but about what we know. And would you help us increase that knowledge of you, that we could just know what and how good a God you are, so that we can have stronger faith. And any obstacles that we may be facing, help us to trust in you that you'll help us defeat it. Help us not to go battle on our own when we have the best champion in our corner. And give us strength, Father Lord, to show that faith in all things that we do so that we can see the reward. We thank you and we pray in your name, amen.
Okay, boys and girls, thank you for joining us this week, and we do look forward to seeing you next week for a great lesson that we would learn from the Word of God. We're excited to have you here. Come on back. The Lord richly bless you, and see you next week.
Praise. I can't stop, won't stop, never gonna stop.